So my brother and I were at Cannes on an assignment from some big production company to film interviews with famous directors who were there to promote their films. I remember filming Roman Polanski and his wife, who was the most beautiful woman I've ever met, the most graceful. And I filmed her dancing. I remember that. So I must try to find that footage. Either we have it or the film company must have a copy of it. One day in Cannes, somebody happened to mention to us that Orson Welles was at Cannes, but he was some 20 miles out of the town at a barroom talking to some people. And if we went out there, we might get an opportunity to meet him. So we drove out, and when we got there and introduced ourselves, I don't think he'd seen any of our films, but he knew who we were and how we worked. And almost right away, he said, well, where are you going from here? I said, well, we're going back to New York. Well, instead, why don't you stop off in Madrid for a week? So we spent a week in Madrid with Orson Welles, going to bullfights, restaurants, but not maybe the first and second day that he began to talk about a film that we should make together about people who go to bullfights and anything that he would want to do and where we would be involved in making it with him. You know, it sounded exciting to us. So we filmed him talking about this film that we'd make. And we ended up with this wonderful little 10-minute piece, which is yet to be put out. And we're hoping to include it with some other films on a DVD that we will market. A film of Muhammad Ali preparing for his last fight. A film of a young American dancing with the Bolshoi Ballet, all kinds of stuff, pieces of films and entire short films that could be put forth on DVD. The other famous and very talented film director was Jean-Luc Godard. I had met Babe Schroeder, who was a film producer and film director to be. I'd met him in New York, and at a time when he was about to leave but had to spend a little more time in New York, and I invited him to stay at my apartment. And it wasn't long before I learned of a film that he was about to make, a film which would be called Paris Vu Par, which is, in English, means Paris as seen by. Well, it's Paris as seen by a number of famous French film directors. Each one would contribute a short 10 to 15 minute piece that would be part of this collection of Paris stories that would be in this film. And one of the objectives of the film was that everything would be shot in 16 millimeter, which was kind of unheard of for a theatrical film, which it would be. But he wanted to promote the notion that the theaters would incorporate a 16 millimeter projector in their theaters by having to show it that way with this film. And so one day, he said, you know, one of the directors is Jean-Luc Godard, and he said, you guys would be great working together. What if I called up Jean-Luc and suggested that you come to be part of the filmmaking, that you would shoot his little story? And I said, well, that would be great. And so he called Jean-Luc and he said, yeah, send him over tomorrow, because everything is all set. So I got there with my camera, and the idea was a revolutionary idea at that, that this piece of fiction would be shot in such a way where the actors would all know exactly what they were to do, and the scene would be lit and all set. And I would walk in at that time and film it the way I would a documentary, just discovering from moment to moment exactly what was going on as I was filming it. And so I think I only shot maybe two or three rolls of film. That's a half an hour, you know. So just about everything that I shot was used because each shot had a continuity that the editor wouldn't want to interrupt. It was so smooth and so good. You know, when you have the opportunity in a fiction film to choose your shots from moment to moment, you do all kinds of things that take away at times the feeling of really being there. But when the camera continues to move with the action, you feel that you're seeing everything that you would if you were there with your own eyes. Anyway, it came across just beautifully and convincingly. It was a kind of a filmmaking that was similar to that of who's that? Shadows.
Cassavetes.
Yeah, similar to. It was a kind of filmmaking similar to Cassavetes, but went one step beyond.